Hello everyone, welcome to this video of IELTS Energy TV. I am going to do another sample part two answer today. A subscriber to this YouTube channel posted this question. He asked me to describe a math skill I learned in primary school. Now, primary school, that's British English. In America, we say elementary school. It's the same. But British English sounds so much better. Like, instead of high school, you can say secondary. Instead of university, you can say tertiary. I love it. It sounds so fancy. Okay. Good vocab for you guys. So I am going to approach this as best I can. I did make notes before. I'm telling you this, just like you guys have to do on the test. And I will post my notes below this video so you can check those out. So there's a couple ways I can approach this. If I have clear memories of learning math, I could tell a story about the teacher or a particular class I remember about math. But honestly, guys, elementary school was a long time ago for me. I know I look super young. No, I'm just kidding. But really, it was a long time ago. So I'm not gonna go the story route, okay? The way I approached this brainstorm, and I did take less than a minute for this, I connected it to, I thought about the math skill that I learned in primary and then how I use it today. So that's how I organized my notes. Okay, so let's open up my timer here. And I will talk for 2 minutes about a math skill I learned in primary school and go. Oh gosh, even when I saw this topic, like just the word math fills me with a bit of unease because I am not a math person. I've always been a language person. So I don't have like really clear or pleasant memories of studying math growing up, let alone elementary school. I mean, what do you learn in elementary school? If I think about what my son is learning, he's in first grade. He's learning subtraction and addition. Got that, nailed that. Second grade is like the times tables, multiplication tables. And then you start getting into fractions and percentages. I remember like really being frustrated with fractions when I was in school. again, not a math person. So if I could think about, if I had to choose one skill, I'm just gonna say the addition and subtraction because that's honestly mostly what I use today, right? I use it in both my professional and personal lives, as I believe every mature adult does. As far as my work goes, I have to use math to calculate my hours that I'm working, to try and figure out how much money I'm gonna earn that month, right? Or looking at all the statistics for our business, like sales numbers and conversion percentages and what tools are working, right? These are all based on math and percentages. And I'm using math a lot more in my job than I ever thought I would. But that's part of exploring business as an adult. So yeah, I definitely use just the simple mathematics in my professional life and my personal life. Because I mean, your personal life, if you're going to invest in your future, you have to start thinking about that, right? Trying to find 401ks and studying the return rates and such, but just daily expenses, like just my overhead for being a person, for being a mom. I have to do a budget, rent, food. We need sustenance, of course, but then all the activities. Oh my gosh, that's over 2 minutes. Okay, so if I were to continue, I also had more notes about buying presents for birthday parties, right? And I don't buy gifts. I don't like buying like just toys anymore for little kids. I like buying experiences for their family. So I like getting them tickets to like a trampoline park or something. Anyway, I have more notes. I'll put them below the video. Okay, so one way, how I introduced that was very honest, right? You can also say something like, now, sad to say, I am not the best math person. So when you're introducing part two, be direct, be honest, okay? Go directly to the topic. Okay, guys, you can watch this video a couple times or more. Of course, it is on YouTube forever and always. So watch this a couple times, note down any interesting transitions and vocabulary that you hear. And if you're ready to invest in yourself and your future, get past IELTS this year, you guys. If that is your goal, Three Keys IELTS is here to help you reach that goal and surpass the scores you need. Go to allearsenglish.com/KEYS. You can see so many students who have gotten amazing scores, guys. So you know it works. We guarantee it works. allearsenglish.com/KEYS. Okay, guys, that's it for me. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.